Welcome to EGO NetCast. I am Martin Lindeskog, solo episode number 98. I was doing moderating and found a post on social platforms on online communities that you should watch in 2020. And discussing different ones. For example, the one TikTok, and it's a Chinese company. And I wonder what would happen if you put like a Falun Gong video on it, or Shen Yun, or reference to Epoch Times. And in the news there, it was also about Saudi Arabia communication app called Tutok. And it led directly to this family in United Arab Emirates. The Sheikhs there. And you have a company called Dark Matter. Chew on that word, Dark Matter. And it's then, as I said, in United Arab Emirates. And I will include in the show notes Wikipedia link there. And also a company on Wired, Peace Fair. And they even have an office in Finland, programmers of this application. And Apple, they took this application down for some time, and also Google Play, I think they put it up again. I don't know how it is on Apple App Store there. And I will include also in, as I said, Epoch Times, an interview there with Jan Matze and Jan Jekilik about how to create an alternative to Twitter plan, and also how Twitter is doing here by saying with this echoing thing. So I will put that in the show notes also. About this growth on this new free speech platform called Parler, or P-A-R-L-E-R. They explain also the name, and it's this French word for speaking or talking, Parler. So I have downloaded this app, and it's interesting to see figures on this platform. I will stick to Twitter, but I want to test out this Parler and see where it could go, and also where we will see new platforms popping up. I think the big ones will still stick around and be here for a long time. But it will be interesting to see, with, as we say in Swedish, you have a word called that you have different opinions and corridors of opinions, and also filter bubbles, and also this political correctness, and how to have a consensus all the time, and what you are not allowed to say. And as I said before, I'm very much for freedom of speech and freedom of expression. Of course, you have to take consequences and take responsibility for what you are saying. But this is very important when we see now backlash on certain opinions and views on platforms like Twitter. And so we'll see following the development here and see if a new alternative for Twitter will come and stay for a long time. It's anyway interesting to check it out and see what will happen in the future with Parler. And I will include that also to the app of Wikipedia, but also the link to the application there, so you could look it out and test it for yourself. So with that, I say cheerio and talk soon again.